Well, we all know that AI is evolving at a rapid pace, and NVIDIA is right there leading the charge. The chip company is powering AI found in products like this laptop right here and plans to make it even more powerful. So today, I welcome Jesse Clayton, NVIDIA's Director of Consumer Products. All right. Thank you so much, Jesse Clayton from NVIDIA, for being here. I want to talk about GPU, AI, and TOPS. So let's start with GPU. I think people have heard these words, you know, maybe in the news or when they're reading about some of these products, but they don't quite understand them. So hit me up here. Let's go.
Right. Okay. So starting with GPU.
Yeah.
The GPU is the processor in your PC that takes on all the really demanding tasks, like 3D graphics for gaming and design and animation, or video processing for editing videos or watching videos, or artificial intelligence, which shows up in gaming and content creation and software development and STEM workloads. Now, a GPU is different from a CPU and that it's designed to run many, many calculations in parallel across hundreds or thousands of computing cores.
Okay, so something like this ASUS here is going to be loaded with all kinds of GPU power, yeah?
That's right, that's right. And so that ASUS has a GeForce RTX GPU in it, and that shares kind of that same core DNA or that core architecture as the GPUs that you see in data centers in the cloud around the world that are really powering the world's AI.
Amazing. So you're taking like these giant cloud-based buildings, essentially, because we know that there's not really in the air in a cloud. For those of you, I'm sorry, I'm ruining that. It is in a building somewhere. And it's shrinking it down, but still just enough power to be able to blow something like this up. Like, it's crazy what these can do in such a small package.
Yeah, it's pretty remarkable. And it all kind of comes down to parallel computing power. So you mentioned the second thing we're going to talk about, which is AI.
Right.
Of course, this is artificial intelligence. And, you know, AI has been around for decades, but it's really been in the last 10 years that there's just been rapid progress in the field. And a large part of that is thanks to NVIDIA GPUs. AI is a parallel computing problem, and GPUs have a parallel computing architecture. And so it makes sense that they would be very good at accelerating artificial intelligence.
And that leads me into TOPS. This was a term that, frankly, I was not aware of in my research. I was reading and I was like, people are just throwing around as a 10 TOPS, 5 TOPS, 20 TOPS. And I was like, I worked restaurants for years. A 2 TOP is 2 people sitting at a table, a 4 TOP is 4 people. But it's clearly not that. And it's kind of mind blowing what it is. So tell me about that.
Sure. Well, you talk about, you know, 2 top or 4 top tables. Here we're talking about trillions of operations, right?
And so I just can't get my mind around that. Trillions of operations per second, right?
It's crazy. It's crazy. And so that's what TOPS stands for. It's trillions of operations per second. And so I mentioned that AI is extremely computationally intensive, which means it needs a lot of math. And so TOPS, it makes sense that the industry is using this as a way to assess the capabilities of different AI accelerators.
And that's what we're going to see in a laptop like this, right? I mean, potentially it's that RTX that makes this such a desirable piece of equipment, specifically for gamers or content creators. It more than just like, oh, it'll help you complete a sentence. We're talking about big time frame rate enhancement and all those elements, right?
That's right. And so there are more than 500 AI-enabled applications and games that are accelerated by RTX today that you can download and you can use right now. You know, across all these different workloads, if you're a gamer, you know you want your game to be visually immersive and beautiful, and you also want it to be the highest performance. Or if you're a content creator, you want your application to run the fastest. And so that's what RTX is going to give you.
Now, I feel like NVIDIA is one of those companies that people recognize, they know the name, they've seen the logos, and I think if you know, asked people, what is this? I think they would know it's computer related or something like that, but how deep is NVIDIA in our daily life? I mean, you guys are kind of everywhere.
Yeah. Yeah, NVIDIA is really a company that's focused on solving the world's big computing challenges. And so, as I mentioned, you'll find NVIDIA GPUs in the data center powering the world's AI. So they're training the next large language model. They're driving the AI that is behind all of the digital assistants and customer service applications. It's also running some of the world's largest scientific simulations. NVIDIA hardware and software is also used in healthcare. So it's giving doctors new tools to diagnose disease, and it's
awesome.
Giving researchers the ability to devise new compounds, new drug compounds to treat disease. As you mentioned, it's used to train and power the AI that's in self-driving cars and robots. GPUs are also used in visual effects for film production. So for example, over the last 15 years, all of the top films for visual effects, the rendering, the work was done on GPUs in that production process.
And they were NVIDIA GPUs.
That's right, NVIDIA GPUs.
Wow.
And so then in your PC, NVIDIA GPUs are what's powering your gaming, your content creation application, and then some of the new emerging things with AI for STEM and AI for productivity use cases.
What did you guys have to overcome to get to where you are today from a standpoint of, was it, you know, a lot of our creators too have spoken about how it was in their head, it was in their brain, but they looked around and it wasn't on the market. Right. Mm-hmm. So either they created a product from scratch or the product was inhibited by a lack of something. Could be lightweight material. It could be access. You know, it was too expensive to use this lens or glass or whatever. So in this case, what was it that happened that allowed? Was it just a whole bunch of people got really smart overnight and then NVIDIA was like, great, a GPU, an RTX, and here we go? Or was there something on your side that kind of like allowed this growth to accelerate?
Yeah. So I think it's several things coming together. There is an awareness of what's happening with the research and how that research will be applicable to things that will end up in products. Then there is the vision for what we need to build, what we need to invest in order to make these products a reality. And then, of course, there's all the engineering that happens with bringing these things together. Now, building that hardware into our GPU, and that is an expensive thing, both from a research investment standpoint, but also that's new hardware, new space on the GPU that we didn't have before. And there's no applications for it yet. And so, you know, if you look at this from just a, you know, product assessment, why are you building something for a product that doesn't really have an application? And so part of it is being able to have that vision and that courage to build something that you believe is going to be relevant in the future. I want to tell you a little bit about something called ACE. So ACE is NVIDIA's platform for digital humans. So this has applications in gaming. It also has applications in advertising and in customer service. But one of the things that you can do with ACE is build into a game world a non-player character or an NPC that is powered by AI. And we showed some demos where you can actually go and interact with these characters. So for example, the way you interact is, you know, you walk up in the game world, you're a character in the game, and you can talk to the character. And so first there's an AI model that is taking my voice that's going into a microphone and converting that to text.
Okay.
Then there's another AI model, a large language model, that is taking that text as input and formulating the response provided by this NPC. Then there's another AI that's taking that text response and creating voice so I can hear it. And then there's another AI model taking that voice and animating the face so that the face moves in a way that's consistent with what's being said.
Yeah.
As you can imagine, it's a lot of work to get all of these things working together, but the result is just magical. And it can lead to some things that are pretty mind-blowing and unbelievable. So let me give you an example. We were at CES earlier this year, and we were demoing this technology. It's through a Kairos demo, and you can go see videos of this online.
Which I will.
And, you know, these are long days. We're in this room, and my colleague is demoing it, and I'm overhearing a lot of it. And so you hear a lot over the course of this day. And later that evening, I was getting ready to go out and meet some partners. In the back of my mind, I was thinking, what was that really funny conversation I heard today? You know, these two people were talking. There's a lot of banter, and it was really funny. And then I realized that this was not a conversation between two people that were talking.
It was actually
a conversation between these two AIs named Jin and Nova that were in the simulation talking to each other. And it was this very kind of free-flowing, natural conversation, but was still consistent with the game world and the lore of the game. And so I mention it because, you know, in my mind, my subconscious, I had presumed that these were actual people. And I think this is kind of an indication of where things are headed. When you take new content and you combine it with the latest AI models and GPUs and acceleration from RTX, it enables you to do things that are literally awe-inspiring.
I love that. And then how about you? Is this something that just gets you totally jazzed? Like, I can't wait for the next frontier? Or does it feel overwhelming? Because sometimes when you have to clean your room and everything's messy, you don't know where to start. Like, you guys, like, there are no limits, it feels like, anymore. So like, where do you go? Sometimes that can be just as paralyzing as like, I don't know where to go. So what about you personally? How do you feel about all this?
Yeah, sometimes it's challenging because it's moving extremely fast.
Yeah.
In fact, I think it's arguably the fastest moving technology in the history of computing, in the history of PCs. And so I think a big part of it is having a vision of, okay, where can we take this and what is it useful for? So there's a number of different different directions that we could take it, but what can we do and what are we uniquely qualified to do to bring to the world that can be used in a number of different ways? And so I mentioned ACE before, NVIDIA's platform for digital humans. This is one vision of the future where we can leverage all these different AIs to have these realistic, helpful human interactions with digital humans that can be used across a wide variety of use cases, like I said, in gaming and customer service and advertising and many more.
Well, as we wrap up here, I have to, of course, ask, am I talking to a real person right now? I mean, because of what you were talking about, it makes me think, wait, are you just in a lounge chair in Cabo somewhere and you're listening to this and your AI model in front of me is just moving around so effortlessly? Because that could be the future too, right?
It's possible. You'll never really know.
Oh, man. That's true. Until maybe you're face-to-face. And then even, who knows, even then. Maybe eventually that becomes some kind of like real thick hologramic type of thing. And I don't know. The future's exciting. I'll say that.
Yeah. Well, what's interesting is, you know, we're going to exist in the physical world as we do, and we'll be existing in digital worlds as well,
yes.
Virtual worlds. And we'll have AIs that also move back and forth between those worlds, like AIs that you converse with in the digital world and then AIs that help you in the physical world as well.
Amazing. Amazing. I love it. Well, I appreciate your time and what you guys are doing at NVIDIA, making our lives easier, more enjoyable, and the future sounds pretty strong for you guys too.
Yeah, we're really excited with everything that's coming out now and how we're able to contribute to it and be a part of it, and excited to see what's coming next.
Love it. Awesome. Well, Jesse Clayton with NVIDIA, thank you so much, and have a great day.
All right. Great. Thanks a lot, Bradley.
All right. Thanks so much for watching and or listening. Make sure you subscribe and let us know in the comments what product you'd like to see next.